In this video, I will share with you how to do an advanced keyword research. With the dive, we will cover everything from market analysis, how to steal sales from your competitors, and how to identify the exact keyword you want to target with your Amazon PPC campaigns to boost your organic rank on Amazon. I'm Stefano Pretto, I'm the CEO at Nomadz. We manage $2 million of Amazon ad spend every single month. And we make this video because we want to share with you what we are doing for our amazing clients so you can do the same for your own brand. And if you sell more than $50,000 on Amazon, you can apply for a free advanced audit of your account. You just need to check the link in the description and you will be able to apply for that. And now let's get started. Okay, we are going to do an analysis for a product that is a protein powder vanilla, and this will be our product. So this is our product. Let's say we assume that this is our product and we want to try to rank better for our keyword. We want to analyze our competitor and we want to find the keyword that we think we could push more for our with our Amazon PPC campaigns. It's a 4.5 product and it's quite new in the market, 800 reviews compared to, for example, 200,000 reviews. So, but it looks like they're doing quite well. So I see that the BSR is improving, which is good. And so let's see what they can do better. So first of all, we need to analyze the market. How can we analyze the market? With Data Dive. So first of all, you need to download the Data Dive Chrome extension. I will add a link in the description. And after, you need to have a Data Dive account. We have a link with a 20% discount, if I'm not mistaken. It's an affiliation link, but if you don't want to use it, you can go and use it without. You just get a good discount if you use our and we get a percentage as well, just to let you know. And here, so the first thing we want to do, so we to download the Chrome extension, have a Data Dive account. And now what we need to do, we need to select the competitors we want to target. So this is the most important part for our keyword research analysis. There is a famous phrase in the software world, which is garbage in, garbage out, which means that if we put into the system garbage, we will get garbage out. And that is for the code, but in our case, it's based on the keyword research. So the results, the keyword that we will get will be based on the competitors we're going to analyze. Let me give you an example. So let's say that we sell a protein powder. And in this case, we want to find keyword only for vanilla flavor. If we use protein powder as our hero keyword, and we're going to analyze this competitor, as you can see, these have different flavors. So what we are going to get if we do an analysis for this product, we are going to get different keywords that we don't care, that we don't want to rank for. In this case, in this example, what we care, it's only protein powder vanilla. So it's very important that if you sell your product, you need to select your hero keyword that needs to be with the highest search volume and relevant for your product. Now that you define your keyword, you need to define the competitors you want to analyze. So, and to do that, you need to click here and dive box. It will take a bit to load. Okay, now the data is ready. So here you can see different metrics. So you can see, for example, for this hero keyword, what is search volume, total revenue, total sales, and so on. So you can see, and this data is sorted by sales. So as you can see, this competitor is the biggest one. And if you want to add that to your dive, you just need to click here. And that will be added to your niche. So you will create a niche. And so let's find the top 10 competitors we want to analyze. And again, this is the most important part. So here I can see that this one is a protein powder, vanilla. So let's add it here. But look at this. This one is not a protein powder. It's a collagen peptides. So it's a different product. We don't want to analyze this. So this one is protein powder. So this is what we want. Protein powder. So this is what we want. This is collagen peptide, so we don't care about this. Protein powder, yes. This is vanilla, yes, it's vanilla. This one is vanilla as well, or no, vanilla, yes. So here we have 6 products for now. We would like to get 10 products if we can. Vanilla, nutrition, whey protein, yes. Whey protein, yes. Yes, let's do it. And also this one with protein. So we have 10 products. So, but what we want to do now, we want to have our ASIN at the beginning of the niche name, and we're going to do a dive. So Now what we are going to do, we are going to analyze all these 10 competitors and we're going to do a reverse aging, a data dive of these products. So let's do it. It will take a bit of time. So usually it takes, depends on the account, but could take up to 5 minutes. Hopefully it will be faster. Okay, amazing. We have our data. First of all, don't get scared by all this amount of data. It's gonna be fine. We're going to discuss everything here. But the first thing we need to do, we need to well, the first thing you can analyze is the data of each competitor, which is very cool. So here at the top right, you can see listing age, and you can sort by sales. So if you select sales, you can see the product that is selling the most. So this product is the product that between the 10 products we analyze is the one that is selling the most by far. So as we saw also before, and you can see different metrics like keyword on product on page one. So I can see that they are everywhere. So they are dominating all the keyword. They are in product page number one for 99% of the keyword. Same things for this the second one. Same things for the third one. But as you can see, like this one that is not selling as much as the first one is not at the top at the product page. The keyword are not in page one. All of them. Only 54% of the keyword are in page one. And we can see many other things. For example, we can see listing age, price, sales revenue. So how much revenue they're making. They're making quite a good revenue, you know, 5 million a month, which is quite good. And the share of voice. So here we can see how much they dominated the niche. So we can see that this product, they can improve. Like this one, it's very weak, but they can, so they can improve a lot. So let's do one thing first. So here we have all our competitor. Here we have different metrics. We can pin and unpin things we want to analyze. And we can also pin some product. But first let me add our product to the dive. So to do that, so if you want to add other products here, you just need to click here, ASINs. And now we're going to add our ASIN here. Add to niche. And now we need to wait again. Hopefully it will be faster. Because soon I need to eat something. Yes, we have it. Okay, so here we added the ASIN. So at the end you can see that we have our ASIN. And what we can do, we can click this, and now we have it at the beginning. So it will be very easy to compare our product to all the other products in this list. So for example, we can see that compared to Optimum Nutrition, we are very weak. I see that we are a US-based seller. I see that we have 5 variation while Optimal has 38 variation. And I can see, for example, the keyword on page one, we have 146, which is 29% of the keyword data that I found compared to 98% compared to Optimum Nutrition. So I see that there is a lot of things we can improve. And now if I scroll down, I can see all the keywords. So here we found 500 keywords. And so as you can see, we have lots of keywords and we have two main metrics, which are search volume and relevancy. So the higher the relevancy, it means that lots of competitors are ranking for this keyword. So it means that they are all relevant for this product. So for example, for vanilla protein powder, I see that our ranking is 10, which is quite good. But for protein powders, it's 41. But best vanilla protein powder, we are ranked 32. So here I already found a few keywords where we could rank better. For example, vanilla protein powder, which is a typo. I can see that all our competitors are well ranked while we are not well ranked. So these are two keywords that they're very relevant, but we are really low on the ranking side. So what we could do, we could add these two keywords, and after we can, I did another video to explain how to use the rank radar with data dive. So go and check that video as well. But you can track these two keywords with data dive, and you can see if by pushing more with PPC, you can gain extra ranking. So if you click here, you can see select 31 keyword that contains brand's name. So here are all the brand keyword, all the keyword contain a brand name inside. And what you can do, you can exclude this from your master keyword list. And we like to do the same. So we don't like to have competitor branded keyword in our master keyword list. So we are going to exclude this. So now it's loading. At the top, you can see the bar that is loading. Okay, so from 500 keyword, now we have 469. So now we have less keyword. And a few other things I want to share with you, like here at the top, you can see the name of the niche and the who is the owner. And here you can you have other metrics. Don't worry about this. So here are all the keywords that you exclude from the master keyword list and the phrases that you exclude or the async. And here you have the niche settings. So you can change the setting of the niche if you want. Do not worry about this. You can check this if you are a bit more advanced. But overall, like these one are quite good. Maybe you can put as an outlier. We remove the minimum from this amount. So maybe you could see 500 here. But yeah, don't worry about too much about this. And then you can share this to outside the organization if you want. And you can always export this file in Excel. So maybe it will be easier for you to analyze the data. One thing you can also do, you can untoggle this. So you will not see the data anymore. You will just see this thing and that's it. So maybe it's easier to analyze. I like to keep this. And I really like to analyze a keyword in page one. So this is a metric I really like to watch. And now what I want to see, I want to find keyword we could try to target with our PPC campaigns. So first of all, we did a market analysis. So we saw that there are a lot of opportunities here. We found the keyword. So we found 469 keyword we could target with our PPC campaigns, or we could add to our listing. And now what I want to show you is, I could show you the outliers. So let me show you quickly. So here, just to recap, in this table, you can see for each keyword, what is the ranking for each product. So if it's red, it means that is the best they can do. Or is if it's a color very close to the red one, it means that they cannot do much better. But if it's a green one, so like for example, this three, here we have a very high relevancy, but our ranking could improve because we are not on the top 10 position. So for example, for our product, so for our nice product here, we could try to push more with PPC for this keyword. And how to do that? What we suggest is single keyword campaign, especially for keyword with quite high search volume. So for this one, for sure, I will create a single keyword campaign where we try to target top of search and we try to be in the search term impression share less than 5. So it means that we are dominating the top of search placement. So that is what we suggest to do. If the search volume is lower, you can put them in a multi-keyword campaign. So sponsor product exact with multiple keyword and always try to push for top of search because top of search has the highest conversion rate. We know that we have also the highest CPC, but it's the best way to improve our ranking. So for sure, like these two keyword, I would for sure try to push them more with PPC because again, high relevancy, high search volume, and quite low ranking. And so here we know that we can improve it. It's relevant for our keyword, for our product, and we can do much better. Okay, so here we discuss about this, and we can see also all our competitors. But I would highly suggest to check this and see what our competitors are doing. And if you have a competitor that you think that is doing, is the quality similar to yours, you can pin this competitor to the beginning and you can analyze your product compared to your competitor. And if you think that your product is providing more value to the customer, maybe you have a lower price or better reviews or same quality, more quantity and same quality, this kind of stuff, I will highly suggest to analyze these two products or these products and see where they're ranking better and where you can do better. And with PPC, go targeted and push more this keyword. I want to show you a few other tabs here, outliers. So the outliers are quite cool because these keywords are the keyword with a low relevancy. But as you can see, our competitor is there as well. So for gold standard whey protein, okay, this is their branded keyword, their position number one. But for unflavored protein powder, this is still ranked for, it's still there. So, and it's 44,000 reviews. Maybe it's not super relevant for our product since our product is vanilla product, so they have a flavor. But what you can do here, you can see all the keywords that are not really relevant, but you can see that our competitor are ranked for. So, for example, proteína para ganar músculo. This is Spanish. I see that our competitor is ranked for and we are not ranked for. Can we add this to our backend and try to rank for this keyword with PPC? Could be an idea. So again, this is another way to find opportunities in the account and to see if we can do something better. And finally, we have this keyword, So this keyword are the keyword with a very low search volume. So this keyword, maybe they will not give you a lot of sales, but what you can do, this keyword have a low search volume, but they're quite relevant. You see like workout protein powder could be a good keyword to rank for. And again, optimum nutrition, it's always there, but we are not there. So that is the difference between why Optimum is selling so much and we are not selling that much, because they are ranked everywhere and we are not. So that is what we want to do. We want to arrive to the same place. Obviously, we cannot do that from one day to another. It takes time. But this is the place where we can analyze that. We can see, okay, this is why they're selling more than us. Obviously, they have more reviews. Obviously, they've been in the market for longer. But the ranking is such a big thing that we can control. I mean, we cannot control 100%, but we can influence with PPC. So highly suggested to analyze this. And thanks to this, you can create campaigns on your PPC account based on what you just discovered here. So there are many other things, but I will do other videos about the rules, the normalizer overview. But if you just analyze this, so if you find the right competitors, so the market to analyze, you analyze the market well, you analyze the keyword and you use this keyword to push in exact top of search, where you want to improve your ranking, you can do very well, because most of the sellers are not doing this stuff. And if you start doing that, you will have a big advantage compared to these other sellers. So I really hope this video was useful. It was a bit longer than usual, but thank you so much for watching until here, and I see you in the next video.